Alrighty then, let's go ahead and take a break from work. Because, just a second to drink something, because I'm fucking thirsty. So, one of the things I wanted to do with Sakura Santa, at least, you know, bring back, because I haven't done it in a while, is basically asking people questions and whatnot, because there's a decent amount of people that watch this shit, so I'm assuming asking questions here and there would probably help, you know, get comments up, so that way you guys would actually fucking talk, instead of being like, "Dad, boobs, fucking, kind of, you know, deal, whatever the case. I don't know the fuck you guys sound like. Everyone who comments don't censor the boobs or whatever the case is, it really sounds pretty annoying in my head, so, you know, that's that. But either way, I guess I'll probably start bringing questions back to videos starting after this, so, you know, get ready to see a bunch of videos after this, be like, here's a question, answer it, and nerds. So, as we go through this, I'll think of something to ask, because I don't have anything in mind right now. Woohoo. I think for today, I'm going to take a break from working at Tsumi's Cafe. I've been there twice now, and I feel like I'm at death's door. Kid, you gotta work harder. How does she do it? It can't just be experience alone. Usually it is. Even so, she makes mistakes too. You're bound to when you're under that kind of pressure. The entire crowd was constantly demanding attention. How no one throws a fit after not getting service is beyond me. Come to think of it, are they there for food, or are they there to see Tsumi? I think it's more Tsumi. That's the question I'm not comfortable with. After all, she's my childhood friend. Having guys stare at her like that, it just doesn't feel right. I keep telling myself that, but what right do I have to say something like, to say anything? I mean, she's under the impression that I've been oblivious for years. Why else would she do all these shameless things? Huh? Someone's knocking on my apartment door. What could it be at this time? This time? What time of day is it? Like, what? It's about time you opened up. Don't you know how cold it is today? Aren't we in an apartment complex? What do you mean how cold it is? The fuck's out there? Are we not in a building? Or is this, there's like a fucking, like, is that my porch or something? What the fuck? I see you too, Itsumi. You don't work today? I had the day off. Actually, now that I think about it, we're on a high floor because Santa, like, came over and was holding by the window, I think. So, yeah. What? Even I have to take breaks sometimes. Even I have to take breaks sometimes. Yeah, it breaks. Okay. Since I had nothing better to do, I wanted to see what you were up to. Well, I look around my apartment. Oh, there's my fleshlight. There's nothing much to say, really. Nothing has changed since you were here last night. I don't think it would. Look at all this porn under your sofa, though. I didn't notice this. It makes me glad that you're one of the few things in my life that doesn't change. Are you that afraid of change? Yes, she moved when she was young. Probably super hates change. Change is scary and can throw your entire life upside down. What did I just say? It's better when things don't change. Change is good here and there, too. So, you know, fucking get over yourself, Itsumi. Do you really think so? I mean, what if you didn't meet me again? Would you have been content with your life as it is? Yeah, here's the change, bitch. I fucking showed up! I keep wanting to slam my desk, but I'm like, no, because then it's going to cause noise and the fucking mic's going to pick it up. But that was also part of the joke, but I don't want to fucking deal with accidentally hitting fucking the keyboard and stopping the recording or some stupid shit. Well, content, but not happy. Maybe change isn't so bad after all. What did I just fucking say? But don't go and make any dramatic changes on me, Koji. I'm gonna fucking sacrifice my words. Fuck. I prefer you the way you are. You mean you prefer me when you can easily tell what I'm thinking? That's an added bonus, but it's just nice to have something absolute in your life. I'm far from absolute, though. She's saying that you're so fucking naive and easy to, think. After all, I'm a much better student than I used to be. Yes, you finally attended that university you always wanted to. University, what's it called? But you didn't look happy, or that happy about it. Well, even if I got into university, I want to call it university. Just university. I got into the university I wanted. It's been a bit lonely, because I don't make friends. That's a nice parallel between me and Koji. but that doesn't really matter now. You're here, so I'm definitely not alone. Yes. I'll make sure you aren't alone, Koji. She looks around the apartment. I have a treat for you. I was like, wait, I worded that wrong. A treat? What kind of treat? Oh, you'll see. She begins to remove her jacket. Oh, here's the treat. Whoa, easy there. I do like looking at your chest, but there's no need to rush it. Just keep watching. Bit by bit, she discards her clothing until something quite pleasing appears before me. I thought we were done with Swim Club. Fuck! I thought we were done with Swim Club. Okay, it hit the ground. Okay, I thought it might hit the bed. Fuck! In case you're wondering what I threw, I ripped up paper, threw it on the ground, I threw a cardboard on the ground, and then I threw a water bottle on the ground, just in case. You guys wouldn't have known, but, it, you know, I ruined the moment, whatever the fucking case is. Damn it! What do you think? This is my high school, this is your high school swimsuit? Why the fuck do you have it still? It looks a little tight on you. Is that a bad thing? Not at all. You never get a chance to see me in it. Yeah, no shit! You never got a chance. Now you may look as much as you want. What kind of present is this? Like, they're not even dating or anything. She's like, here's a present. Look at my body more. I can't help but notice how badly the swimsuit is straining in the chest area. Did they give you a smaller size at the start of high school? Yes, then I just grew and grew. I was wondering when it was going to happen. She pokes at the chest area on the suit. I swear that I see a growing seam on the side of it. Didn't you used to like school swimsuits? I remember you talking about high school and how you wanted to see so... I assumed that was going to be the issue. It's like, I was like, what is this fucking fetish? is this a kink of his? Fuck it, we're kink shaming. Fuck. For some reason I thought like she was gonna, because with all the outfits they usually like kind of do, at least in fucking Swim Club, you know, you get the fucking, wait, funny enough they had the bunny outfit in Swim Club, huh? Is this supposed to be some kind of parallel? I don't fucking know. I'm thinking too much into it. I don't think they might have planned that far ahead. They did talk about how the fucking paintings were basically like beach, or allude to the fact it's like beach. So maybe they did plan that far ahead. I don't fucking know. Maybe these guys are geniuses and I'm an idiot. Maybe I've been fucking wrong this entire time. Who knows? You do. I don't. That she manages it. I really did have a thing for swimsuits. I don't. To think they designed these things deliberately to be non-arousing. But how people fetishize it was fetish. I thought so. Fetishize the men everywhere. Words. I don't know how to feel about that. It certainly is ironic. Quick, here's the question. Not that you fucked up question. I'm sure people probably know what I was going to say, but, you know, no. So you can see me in one right now. Now, why does it have a seam here? A seam? Where? Look downward. Yeah, I was wondering about that. She tugs at the lower half of the swimsuit, showing off little bits of skin with each pull. She's still not wearing a bra, is she? Or is she? I don't fucking know. Why don't you come lie on my lap, Koji? Yes, Koji, go do it. She sits on the lounge and gestures towards me. Your lap? Yes. Well, I might as well. Resting my head on her lap, I feel her playing with my hair, gently stroking my head. That explains why we're looking at it like this way, I guess you could say. That's a lie. Perspective. The entire time, I keep glancing up and seeing two wobbling blue mountains. Why are they always mountains? Blue Mountain was the name of a show, wasn't it? On Spike? I think it was, actually. No, was it Blue Mountain? Blue Mountain Creek or something like that. I don't remember. I never saw it. I just remember it was a show. This really is the best seat in the house. When was the last time we did this? Fucking, who would know this? I don't remember, but you definitely weren't wearing a swimsuit or school swimsuit when it happened. So he just has a thing for school swimsuits, not normal swimsuits? Right. It was right before you were going to leave. Do you remember that night, Koji? I remember all the tears. I still remember everything that happened then. Tears. Her words grow melancholy. Really shouldn't be drinking energy drinks because I'm burping a little bit. I might have popped up at some point. Melancholic? Is that what it's supposed to be? It's supposed to be like melancholy. Words! Alright, whatever. Burps. her words grow melancholic. Melancholic? That's a weird word. Despite her blank expression. I know what it is, but speaking words out loud always weird. Oh, I shouldn't be talking about the past so sadly. This is sadly? It sounds like you're fucking, you know, this sounds like sensual music going on. Are you enjoying the view, Koji? Of course I am. This view is one of the most glorious I have ever seen. Pervert, pretty much. I know I am. Oh, that's the end of the scene, awesome. For the next hour or so, I just lay there, and that's the entire hour? Just an hour of just laying there and be like, I'm just gonna stare and stare. Stay in 1 hour or so. I feel like that would you know, you'd be like, time to go do something else, I guess. Whatever. This kid really likes swimsuits, so I mean, I don't know. Maybe that's just, he's like, this is a thing I'll never be able to do ever again. Live it up a bit. Am I feeling that way about her? I think I am. When I saw her again, I wasn't sure how to feel about her. I know about her feelings, but I don't know about my own. It wouldn't surprise me now. After all, everything I do with her feels so intimate. Laying my head on her lap shouldn't embarrass a veteran pervert like me, but even then... Veteran pervert, he fucking says. Your face is red, Koji. Where's your swimsuit? How come that doesn't get its own fucking special thing? I don't fucking know. She's back in her normal clothes now. It's an odd day to be wearing a swimsuit under your clothes, Itsumi. Also, why? Why don't you just... change into it. What does it matter? After all, I wanted you to enjoy it. That's the only thing that mattered to me. She continues to sit there. So, did you enjoy that, Koji? Yes. Yes, I did. I'm glad. It seems that you're just a bit embarrassed about it, too. What is the legendary perviness that prevents you from feeling shame? Where's legendary pervert? What am I fucking reading? Whatever, fuck it. It's gone somewhere else for the time being. Is that so? I guess there are moments when even you're awkward, Koji. Not even seeing me in the nude made you blush like that. This really isn't the same because, you know, there was a target and you hit the bullseye and you hit the bullseye. It's not. What's different about it? It just feels different. I wonder why that's the case. Because of the swimsuit. The answer's obvious. It's intimacy. Something I haven't experienced a lot of since middle school. You haven't experienced it since middle school? The fuck were you doing in high school, kid? Then again, not a lot of people actually fucking date in high school or middle school to begin with, so I mean, it's not really actually odd there. I just feel like fucking shitting on this character. So shut up. Just sitting there and having someone pay attention to you like that. It's really nice. Koji, have you ever noticed anything about me? Notice anything? Like what? I mean, do you think there's any significance behind my action? I think so! Well, we're childhood friends. It's natural that we're close. I'm avoiding the question and playing the fool. No, Koji, I'm dying of cancer. Yelling in the background. Just randomly... People argue about stupid shit again. And it's not even arguing, it's just yelling. Just raising voices. I mean... She stops herself before she can say it. Look, if you want to say something to me, go ahead and say it. No, figure it out. Figure out that you almost broke a promise or some shit. You can tell me anything, Itsumi. After all, we know each other really well. We're cousins! That'd be the most fucked up thing, actually. I don't think this is something we'll avoid this time. If I were to take a guess, she's finally going to admit her feelings. Oh, this is going to be the heartbreaking part. Then we go back to her and be like, I have feelings. Listen, Koji, there's something you should know. You're getting married. Yeah, what's the matter, Tsumi? There's been something I've wanted to say to you for a long time, but I never had the courage to say it.
You're a fuck-up.
She's struggling to say it, but I already know what she's going to say. I like you, Koji. Of course what she's gonna fucking say. What else would she fucking say? I know. Eh. That is the face of someone who's dead on the inside like the other characters get. That fucking face isn't shock. It's like fucking despair or something. You knew the entire time? Yeah, I knew. Since how long have you known? I pretty much knew the minute you started flirting with me. I'm not that dense. When a girl likes you, it's pretty obvious. So, yes, I pretty much knew from the beginning. You may not be dense, but you're an idiot. Excuse me? Why didn't you say something earlier, Koji? is this where it's gonna get fucked up now? Why? This entire time I was thinking about how much I regretted never confessing to you. Yet you knew the whole time. And you just leave me here suffering. Oh, wow. Okay, so this is how Koji's a terrible person this time around. Or something to that extent. You're a horrible person, Koji. He kind of is. Why? Just why? Why didn't you say anything to me? Why didn't he? You were going to leave soon. If we started dating, then you were forced to leave. Wouldn't you just felt much, much worse about it? No. What felt worse was years of regret. Year after year at Christmas, I thought about how I should have confessed to you. And how we might have been able to make it work even if we were apart. But instead of having some kind of closure with my feelings, I've been living with my regrets. So what will you do about that, Koji? Tell you not to live with regret? I don't fucking know. Which is kind of what I don't know what to do. Do you not like me? Is that why you never said anything? Do you not like me? It's not like that, isn't it? The whole time you said that you liked women with curves. Do you know how much that made me feel? Wow. I'm more than that, Koji. I only showed off because I thought it would get you to look at me, and he has been. But you knew the whole time how I felt. That's a horrible thing to do to me. Didn't you once care about how I felt, Koji? I thought it was going to be some kind of promise issue, but surprisingly it's not. Why didn't you answer those feelings if you knew they were there? Don't you think you owed me that much if you knew that I was leaving? Even if you rejected me, it would have been better than waiting all these years, never knowing how it could have worked out. She takes a few deep breaths, trying her best not to burst into tears. Wow, Koji, you're kind of a fucking scumbag. Kind of like what I've been thinking about this entire time, but you know, now it's coming to light. So yes, this is the best way to fucking end a series. 2 minutes, not over yet. Fuck. Why didn't you? I'm so sorry. Is that all you have to say? Please, Koji. Can't you say something else? Can't you give me an answer? And the answer is yes, obviously, but we gotta get to that part. She's really upset at the moment. I obviously handled this the wrong way. Not once did I think about it that way. Now I don't know what I should do to make things better. Go out on a date! Listen, it's not like I'm not attracted to you. That much is obvious, right? Yes. But do you love me? If you didn't say anything then maybe you didn't feel anything. Maybe if I confess, I would have just been rejected anyway. Were my feelings for nothing? Quietly, she adjusts her clothes and begins to walk towards the door. Wow. Always getting heavy for these parts. Surprisingly enough. Wait, Itsumi. I need to go home. Tomorrow's going to be busy again. I open my mouth to say something, but she just stares blankly back at me. Without another word, she steps out of my apartment and quietly closes the door behind her. I messed up, didn't I? I haven't really done much since Tsumi left. All I could do is just lie here, staring at the ceiling, thinking about how I could have handled that a lot better. She really is mad at me. I don't think I've ever seen her frown until today. That should really put into perspective how badly I messed this up. I need to distract myself for a moment. There's a few unopened boxes of things from when I moved in here. Maybe I should unpack them. Oh, wait until he finds the thing about those two being the best of friends. Anything would be better than sitting here, being depressed. A fine layer of dust is built up on the boxes. When did I even bring these boxes? Yeah, when did you bring these boxes? I hardly remember most of the stuff I packed up when I left home. How long have you been living here and you haven't unpacked everything yet? My parents also helped with packing, so who knows what else they threw in there. As I pull open the first letter box, or first box, it's probably gonna be a letter, but the first thing which greets my eyes looks strangely familiar. Now, where have I seen this before? As I brush the dust off, what lies beneath becomes apparent. Oh, I remember this board game. It used to be a Christmas tradition between Itsumi's family and my family. Bring the board game with you and play it together. We'd all get together and play until midnight. I remember that we'd try to make the game go on for as long as we could, so we could stay awake to see Santa. Of course, our parents always put us to bed eventually. Usually we pass out before they finish the game. Each year, we'd compete for a small prize. It was a toy or something. In the end though, regardless of who won, we ended up sharing the toy. I remember one year, when it was a stuffed rabbit up for grabs. Itsumi practically fell in love with that little toy. This is just a board game. It may seem like useless junk to most people, but to us, it'll always be something special. I wonder if Itsumi remembers all this too. Maybe it's because she remembers everything we did together that it hurts so much for her. After all, I'm someone who's been there for more than half her life. As I put it down, I realize what it is I have to do. Play this board game with her! Or confess your love. Either or. There's no way that I could just throw away all those years we'd spent together. Even this in this apartment, I brought along things which reminds me of her. So, I'll go help at her cafe, once again. If I have to go once more onto the breach for her, then I'll gladly do it. There's no way she's going to be able to handle that alone. I'm hardly going to look like a knight in shining armor to her. But at the very least, I'll be able to keep my promise. Someone with no conviction is someone no one can rely on. And I want to be someone Itsumi can rely on, no matter how rough things get. She really didn't know that I knew. No wonder she was upset with me. The minute that I knew, I probably should have said something. Yet, what do I say now? Daichi said the best thing to do was to try to make up with her. However, it takes a lot of courage to make that first step. So I have to go see her at work eventually. I think that I should probably give her some time to cool off first. When the time comes, I'll turn up to work and help out with the Christmas crowds. I hope this works. After being separated from each other for so long, I don't want this to be the way things end. Still, it might be good to do something else today. I'm going to need a clear head when I go see her. So Itsumi, please wait for me. I promise that we'll sort things out.
We're gonna really need a thing to do the thing.
I didn't ask a question yet. Fuck. Well, that's a good thing I said I was gonna do this question thing again. Okay, so here's a question then, I guess. So far, out of all these storylines, what do you think is the more heartbreaking part? You know, out of the three main storylines, I guess, you know? Was it more heartbreaking with the whole fucking Santa breaking all the toys and potentially not being able to make all the toys in time? Was it more heartbreaking that fucking Foxgirl was, you know, breaking rules and being selfish, whatever the case you want to go with that one is? Or is this more heartbreaking with the whole best friends thing, secretly knowing about liking and then kind of being just shot down entirely? I don't know. Post in the comments down below, maybe. And then after that, we'll get to the next part, which is...